Emma. Today I'll be showing you how to create a Scandinavia style vector element like this one in Adobe Illustrator. If we take a look at traditional folk design, we can see a common combination of organic lines, symmetry, and natural motifs, which we'll be trying to recreate in this tutorial. Before starting the tutorial, I recommend searching online and trying to build up as many resources as possible which come from this style. These will help demonstrate more of the forms and ideas we're going to be covering in this lesson, as well as giving you ideas and sources for colours and patterns. So to start off with, open up your version of Illustrator. I'm using Creative Cloud version 2015. Then go to File, New, and we're going to call it Scandinavia Pattern. Then we're going to give it a width of 2000 and a height of 2000 pixels, and then click OK. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get my rulers up for later. So to make sure they're up, I'm just going to press Ctrl R on my keyboard. Okay, so now we're going to begin with creating the laurels for our pattern. So draw a straight line by holding down Shift with the tool line. Then click right on the line and select Make Guide. Using my pen tool again, I'm going to click on the guideline, click on it again, further down, and holding down on this point, I'm going to drag out my line. Then I'm going to release my left click and hit Escape on my keyboard to exit the shape. Then click again on the point we just made and connect it to the other point on top. Then I'll give it a fill of blue. So this is half of our leaf. Then with my selection tool, I'm going to left click on the leaf. I'm going to hit O on my keyboard, click on the guideline, hold down Alt, then click again on my guide to reflect. Then I'm going to make that fill colour slightly darker. So now we have both sides. To finish, I'm going to select my guides and lock it by pressing Ctrl 2 on my keyboard. With it locked, I can now select my two halves of the leaves, and by grouping them with Ctrl G, they are now one shape I can move easily together. So now I'm going to move it to the side. Now I'm going to draw my stalk, so I'm going to press the pen tool again, clicking on my guide, and hold down Shift to make it straight, and then click again. I'm going to use the eyedrop tool to make it the same colour as my leaf, and then I'm going to use the swap button to make it a stroke colour. With this set up, I'll now change the size of the line to 16 points. Then I'm going to hold down Alt on my keyboard, I'm going to click on my leaf, and drag it to the stalk to copy it across. Now I'll resize and rotate it in place using Shift when scaling to keep the scale. And I'm happy, I'll copy it down using Alt and then drag again. And when I'm happy with the spacing, I'll use Ctrl D to repeat the action two more times. To reflect everything, I'll select all of my leaves, I'll hit O and I'll click on the guide again. Then I'll hold down Alt and click again, and that will reflect them across. So now I've got a leaf and a laurel, but I want a bendy laurel. So I'm going to copy across my laurel and rotate it around 90 degrees. Then I'm going to group it using Ctrl G again. Then I'm going to go to Effect and then Arch. And I can play around with the bend like this. But I think I'm going to go for a value of 40%. Then I'm going to press Object and Expand. And that's my bent laurel of leaves. Okay, so I'm going to put these to the side and continue working on this board. I'm going to now make a more hand-drawn, uneven laurel. This is to give the pattern more of a handmade look. I sped up this part, but it's made using the same techniques as before, only this time the leaf is made up of one unreflected shape. Then I've just used a combination of copying and moving the leaves around the stem to create my laurel. Okay, so next up is the heart. So to make this, I get my pen tool, I draw out one side of the heart by using straight lines, which I'm going to get by holding down Shift. And what this does is it creates a 45 degree angle, which I find is easier for me to make the heart. Then, when I'm happy with the shape and it's closed, I then use the white arrow, which is a direct selection tool, to select the outside corners. With these on, I can get a curve in my shape by pulling in the highlighted white dots. I'll hit O and I'll click on the guide again. Then I'll hold down Alt and click again, and that will reflect them across. Then I get up my Pathfinder by using Windows Pathfinder. I use the Unite tool from this to join the shapes together. And then on my taskbar, I go to Object, Path, Simplify. And you can see that that gives you a better heart shape, so it's a bit more rounded now. Now I want something more detailed, so I'm going to press S and then Enter and type in a value of 120% uniform. Then I'll click Copy. And this makes a bigger version of my heart using the scale tool. Then I'll right click, arrange center back, and use the eyedropper tool to select a darker color. Next, I've made a flower. Again, this is made using most of the techniques we've covered, which are the pen tool, corner tool, copy, rotate, and then finally making everything one shape with the Pathfinder Unite tool, which you can see. Finally, I use the circle tool to make a centre. Okay, the last and maybe most important step is our animal. For this step, you'll need an image of an animal to work from, and then save it to your computer. I'm going to go to the file and then place it to drop it into my file. And then I'm going to use the pen tool to trace around the body and head of the horse. Once I finish this, I'll just round some corners and then delete my working image. Okay, so now I've got all my elements, we can start to make the pattern. As you can see, I just added some more elements and detail to my work. I've now got this sort of teardrop shape, which is just made using a petal shape, copying it, reflecting it, and then decorating it with circles. And also I've added these decorative elements to my heart, which I'm just going to reflect. So to begin with, I'm going to delete the guide. So I'll hit Ctrl+Alt+2 to unlock the lines, and then select them to delete. Now I'm going to make our centre line. So I'm going to click on my ruler to the side and drag, and then drag out again, and once more so we have three lines. I'm going to line them up with our artboard like this. Then I'm going to go to my window line and press vertical align here. So now with that done, I'm going to take my horse first. I'll scale him up. Press the O button, reflect through my guide, and copy him across using Alt. Now I'm going to use my pen tool and roughly mark out where I think there's potential for the negative space to be made into a pattern. Now that I've got that planned out, I'm going to move everything up till it's centered, and then I'll start dragging my elements out. So I think I'll start with this element first. And to make sure any elements in the middle are definitely in the middle, I'm going to go to Align, to Key Object, and make sure my guide is highlighted, and then click on Vertical Align. So now I'll just move the others in place, making sure to delete the rough pen lines as I go along. And I'll try and stick to one side so I can reflect everything as one, although you can play around with this as you go along to check. As you can see, I end up reflecting everything, but then making some changes. However, the end result is a symmetrical image. Okay, with my final image, I'll now show you how to easily change the colours. So I'm going to go and I'm going to insert a background in first using the rectangle tool. And in my case, it's got like a pinkish fill. Then I'm going to right click and center back. Selecting everything with my select tool, I'm going to go to edit, edit colors, recolor. And here I can easily play about and change the colors. So let's say I want to change the blue to red. I simply click on the color and change my color like this. If I double click on the color, I can go to color swatch and change it to any of the colors in my swatches. And then from here, I can carry colors across to either swap them or have them the same. And I can add colors to the harmony. In the end, I've used a combination of edit colors and just working in the document to create this pink, red, and blue color scheme. And that's it. I hope you've enjoyed the tutorial, and I look forward to seeing you next time.